In this session, we are going to discuss loop constructs in our C programming. So in our C programming, we can do the looping mainly using these three options. So using for, using while, and using do while. In other programming languages like say Pascal or some other languages are there where we are having another looping construct, that is the repeat until. The basic difference between these three constructs, that is for, while, and do while, and this repeat until, is that here this looping will take place when the condition is true and it will come out when the condition will become false. But here this looping will take place when the condition is false and the loop will get terminated when the condition will get true. But this repeat until is not available in our dev C++. So that's why we are going to discuss this for, while, and do while, these three looping constructs in our demonstration. So here is the one demonstration for you, where we shall go on doing the coding and execution for the better understanding on this loop construct. So please watch the demonstration. The common loop construct in C programming is our for loop. So how to write a for loop? Int I, that means we have defined one variable with the name I. For I is equal to 0, so initially the I will have the value 0. I less than equal to 5, that means I can get up to value 5, and by increasing I plus plus, that means each and every time the value of I will be incremented by 1. So if this condition is satisfying, then the control will come in this for loop body. So printf iteration using for with I is equal to %d. So here this I will be coming down here. After exiting the loop, I want to print the current value of I. So here we are doing the looping or iteration using for construct. So let me execute my code at first. So if I execute my code, this is my code and this is my execution output. Iteration using for loop, that means this line got executed. Iteration using for with I is equal to %d. So here this value of I is ranging from 0 to 5. Here initially I have put the value of I is equal to 0. So in this way, for I is equal to 0 to 5, that means this loop has got executed for 6 number of times. So starting from 0 to 5, each and every time it is getting incremented by 1. And after exiting this for loop, and this line is getting printed, and here it is printing the value of I is equal to 6. Because after incrementing value of I from 5 to 6 by 1, in the case 6 is less than equal to 5, this condition will be false. So it will come out from this loop, and this after exiting loop I is equal to 6 will get printed. So that means after exiting the for loop, the value of I is not remaining with 5, but it is remaining with 6, and 6 is less than equal to 5. This condition was false, so that's why it came out from the for loop construct. Okay, in this way the code is getting executed. So if I put here 1, so I'm supposed to get executed this particular line for 5 times. So that means from 1 to 5 accordingly. So this is my code, this is my output. You can tally them and get the logic. Now let me uncomment this do while. Let me uncomment this do while construct. Here the value of I, I'm initializing with 1, and then do iteration using do while with I is equal to %d. So here this I is getting printed, and each and every time the value of I is getting incremented by 1 by writing I plus plus, while I is less than equal to 5. That means the I can be maximum 5, for which this loop will go on executing. Let me see the output at first for the better understanding. So this is the output. So I should concentrate this part. So iteration using do while. So iteration using do while. Iteration using do while with I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And similarly, after exiting the loop, the value of I will be 6 in that case. So when the value of I will be 6, after printing 5, I is getting incremented by 1. So the value of I is becoming 6. 6 is less than equal to 5. This condition is false. So it is coming out. And if I print the value of I, it is printing value 6. Okay, now let me print the last one, and that is our while do construct.
We are telling it as while do, but actually, in case of C programming, we should have to write only while do will remain silent for that. So I'm going for uncomment. Going for uncomment, and now I'm going to print this output on the output window. So this is the full output of the program. So iteration using while do I is equal to 1 while I is less than equal to 5. Here you see there is no do. Do is remaining silent. Printf iteration using while do with I is equal to percentage D. So I is getting printed each and every time the value of I is incrementing is getting incremented by 1. So you see this is the output. So while do with I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And obviously in the same logic, using the same logic, when I shall come out from this while do construct, then this value of I is going to get printed as 6. The question is coming in mind, then what is the difference between do while and while do? The basic difference here is that after do, before checking anything, the body is getting executed. Then the checking is being done. But here at first the checking is being done, then the body is getting executed if the condition is true. So for the better understanding, I'm putting this i is equal to 10 and I is equal to 10 here. So let me execute the code again. Here you see as the value of I is equal to 10 at first. So 10 is less than equal to 5. This condition is false. So this line was unreachable and remain unexecuted here. You cannot find this line. But here this value of I is equal to 10. But you see the condition checked has been done after executing the do body once at least. So that's why this line got execution once. This line got execution once. But in this case, as the condition is getting checked at first before executing the body, so that iteration line, iteration using while do is not getting executed once at least. So that's why in case of do while, the body of the do will be executed at least once and then it will go for checking with the while. But in case of while do, the checking has been done at first. So if the condition is not true at the very beginning, then the body will not get executed for at least once even. So that is the basic difference between these two. So also I can be writing this one outside of the loop. If you execute, we are going to get the same output. So let me put this one as 0, making this one as say 1. So now let me execute the code. It is having one error. It is telling that semicolon is missing. So that's why it is causing problem. So now if I execute the code, the output is remaining the same. That means this initialization of I can be done prior entering in the for loop, and this incrementing of this I should be done, can also be done within the for body, but the semicolons must be there, and that indicates that it is the second component, that is the condition check. So in this way also you can write your for loop construct. Thanks for watching this video.